Hello ladies and gentlemen, my name is Mr. Tardis and here's just a really quick update video. I plan to do these every couple of months just to let you all know what's going on with the channel and any updates and just letting you know what to expect over the next few weeks and months. So I just wanted to mainly do this video because Series 11 is out and I just wanted to let you know what that would mean for the channel, what videos I plan to be doing. And also over the past couple of weeks I've had a pretty substantial new boom of subscribers. I've had about 600 people join over the past like couple of weeks alone, which for many big channels isn't that many, but considering the size of my channel, it's probably the biggest boost, it's probably the biggest single growth in subscribers that I've ever had, I think. So I just wanted to thank all of you newcomers, welcome you all to the channel, hello. If you wanted me to be one of those channels that just lambasts Doctor Who for every single thing it does, then you are, I'm afraid, in the wrong place, but I hope you enjoy your time here anyway. So with Series 11 out, what can you expect from the channel? There will be no in-depth reviews of the new stories. There will be these reaction videos that I'm planning to do, which will be unscripted, 10, 15, maybe 20 minute long audio videos talking about my thoughts on the episode very shortly after it's broadcast. I plan on uploading these every Monday. Whether or not I may be a day or two late, that remains to be seen, but I'm going to try and make Monday brand new Doctor Who Day. For Tuesdays, I'll be laying out the viewing figures. I'll be talking about the overnight figures for the episode just broadcast, and I'll be talking about the 7-day consolidated figure for the episode that came the week before. For example, this Tuesday, expect a video about the overnights for the Ghost Monument, and then also talking about the 7-day figures for the woman who fell to Earth. And for the rest of the week, I don't really have anything set, whether it's a discussion video or a vlog like this, or just something random and fun. I'll try and do that. I'll try and do another video to fill that gap between the Tuesday and the next Monday release. As for the in-depth edited videos, the next one of those is going to be the review of Hyde, the Series 7 story starring Matt Smith and Jenna Coleman. That review is well underway. I'm quite deep into the writing process, and then it comes to the recording and the editing. The writing and the editing are always the most time-consuming part, but I'll try and keep you updated on my Facebook page and my Twitter when I hit each of those milestones. I can't really give you a time as to when you'll see those reviews, and I couldn't even give you an accurate time if I wanted to, because of BBC's terrible copyright policies implemented on YouTube, where they say they have copyrighted policies, but because YouTube is not their platform, they can't actually enforce those policies, meaning that even if I were to upload a video tomorrow, it could take up to 2 months for you to actually see it, for it to be made publicly available. But like I said, just keep up to date with my Facebook and my Twitters. There'll be links in the comment section below or in the description below. You can keep up to date with all of that. I also wanted to just thank you for the incredibly unanimously positive reception to my Heaven Sent shot-by-shot video. I'm really happy with how that turned out. I would love to do more shot-by-shot videos in the future. For the next one, I'm thinking Dalek, but I haven't set that in stone yet. I want to get the Hyde review out of the way and then see how I feel about it. Also, I want to maybe try and get the Christmas Invasion reviewed by Christmas, but the issue is that I could definitely have it finished and done by Christmas, but because of the BBC's copyright policies on YouTube, it might not even be viewable until February. So I don't quite know how to play that. To definitely get it ready for Christmas Day and have it viewable for Christmas Day, I would need to have it ready by October 25th, and I don't know if I can do that. And I don't really know if I'm actually in the mindset to do it when I'm so currently ingrained thinking about the review of Hyde. To be fair, that's on me. I could have planned even more months in advance, but if I'm planning like 4 or 5 months in advance for a review, I think that's maybe just too much. There is such a thing as over-preparing, and I would rather just focus on things that I'm motivated to do. Like, I was not motivated to do the Christmas Invasion review 2 months ago, even though doing it 2 months ago might have meant it would definitely, definitely be ready by Christmas. Despite the growth this channel has seen over the past few weeks and months, this is still quite a small channel, and this is a one-man operation. I have someone do my title cards, and if I need somebody to do the odd graphic or piece of art here and there, then that is kind of the extent of the collaborative process of this channel. And with that in mind, I hugely appreciate your patience in waiting for the in-depth videos. So the next one's going to be Hyde, maybe the Christmas Invasion, which could come out in February. I could even make a joke about that. I don't know. It's too early to say. And maybe a shot-by-shot analysis of Dalek. So outside of the Mr. Tardis Reviews channel, my Trilby Reviews, my movie media-related channel, was taken down a few months ago for spam, scams, or deceptive practices, or whatever. And after literally about 3 months back and forth, possibly talking to automated users, YouTube email responses. I don't know how much of it was done by real people and how much of it was automated. After about 3 months, I finally got the channel back. No sorry, no apology, no promises to try and make sure that this illegitimate strike does not happen again. Just, oh, your channel's back up, we looked at it, it took 3 months, but we finally looked at it and we think that it was fine. That's really frustrating, but the positive side is that during that time I was working a pretty intensive TV job where I was working about 12 to 13 hour days, 5 days a week, which meant I would have found it very difficult to dedicate time to that channel. I'm now not doing that job, I'm between jobs at the moment, so I do have more free time. But that channel, my Trilby Reviews channel, you can find it in the description below. I've recently uploaded reviews of Venom and Johnny English Strikes Again. I don't quite know what to do with the channel now. I kind of lost motivation for it after YouTube just decided to, out of nowhere, just take it down. And I found myself much more motivated to work on the Mr. TARDIS Reviews channel. So kind of splitting my attentions towards the two channels for big in-depth videos, I don't think I'm, as a one-person unit, I don't currently think I'm able to do it. I am going to put the Film Brits podcast on hiatus, but what I'll do with that channel is when I see a film, I'll do a short audio video review of it, and I'll just see how I feel in a few weeks or months times. But I'd like to know what you folks, if you folks are subscribed to the Trilby Reviews YouTube channel, what do you want to see out of it? Do you want more podcasts? Are you just happy with the movie reviews? Do you want the in-depth analytical content? Because what I did with that channel for the past like year and a half, 2 years, is just try and do these smaller videos just to keep the channel running and trying to keep YouTube's algorithm happy. However, there was very little growth from that channel despite me trying to appease the algorithm, which means that I may just have to stop doing that entirely and just do a case of, if I do an in-depth video, it's done when it's done, and just upload it and put it on that channel. I don't currently know what I want to do with it, so I'm just going to sit on that thought and I'll report to you back when I have a more concrete idea. But if you are new here and you're only just discovering for the first time that I do have a second YouTube channel, then feel free to subscribe to the Trilby Reviews channel. Like I said, I've got a few new reviews up there and I'm going to keep on doing regular movie reviews for the time being until I discover what type of content will be on that channel. And a few other things, I'm still working on my short film Before He Wakes, which is a horror drama short film. I just need one more day left of filming to complete it. But the issue is that because a lot of people working on it are volunteers or they're doing it out of their own free time, it's very hard to organise the crew to get together for one day. So that's the main hurdle, but the rest of it, post-production wise, is coming together really, really well. I've been getting music tracks and editing rough cuts of the scenes together, and it's been a pretty really fulfilling experience just putting that together and seeing something that I've created from the ground up, a completely original idea from what I can tell, just start to take form, and that's really satisfying. Also, I attended VwarpCon about a month and a bit ago. I have all the footage on my phone. I recorded lots of content for that, and I actually got a really like a pretty cool haul of things that I want to showcase. I've just not had time to edit that video. I want to try and do a VwarP vlog video. It may be way too late to do it, but I just want to do it anyway, because I had a great time that day. It was amazing meeting so many of you people there. All of you who came over to say hi, who wanted pictures, who wanted selfies. That was a really humbling experience, and I'm glad that it seemed that everyone had a really great day of VwarP. And it's been announced that VwarP 2 is going to be coming to Manchester next September, so I'll hopefully see you all again there. And who knows, maybe if the demand is there, I could speak to the people at VwarP and see if I could do a panel or something. I don't know. There was a lot of people at VwarP who seemed to recognise me, so I think in terms of people who would go to VwarP, there may be an audience there. I have no idea, but who knows, that could be fun. If there's the demand for it, go let the people at VwarP know that you want to see Mr. TARDIS Reviews at VwarP next year. I don't know, the Time Lady's got a panel which was amazing. It was a standing room only panel because the turnout was so amazing. So I think there's a demand for that, about having these online Doctor Who YouTube personalities, or online, because Time Ladies aren't on YouTube, I guess their own, these online personalities having a space at these fan-focused conventions. So who knows, I think that'd be really fun, and I'd be totally up for doing it if they wanted me, of course. Oh, and one more thing, I'm going to be out of town this weekend, so I'm not going to be able to watch the Ghost Monument live, but I will be back on Monday morning. I will watch it as soon as I get in Monday morning, and then have my reaction video up by 5 or 6 p.m. Monday afternoon. But if you follow my social media feeds for instant reactions to Doc 2 episodes this weekend, I'm afraid you're not going to get it. But still, follow me in the social media feeds in the description below, Twitter and Facebook. I'm also on Instagram, at Trilby. So thank you very much for listening to this update video. I'll see you in a few months with another one, and I will see you folks next time.